Hey guys, happy Monday to you. I had to kind of dry my hair a little bit after that last video. Semi-serious topic. Oh, before I get to that, I apologize to my viewers who aren't aware of the trolls and the whack jobs and the other folks that are out here on YouTube. You probably haven't run into them. They have a tendency to circle around my channel sometimes. So just ignore them. Don't respond to them. I usually try and do that stuff over on the UDM Raw channel, which is my, speak out, do adult responses, and entertainment channel, which these guys are definitely entertainment. So don't pay much attention to them. It was an interesting day today. I started by reading this article about a phone calls database being considered in the UK, and ministers are to consider plans for a database of electronic information holding details of every phone call and email sent in the UK. And the story kind of struck me odd because, you know, I work in the information security business a little bit anyway, or I have in the last year, and one of the things that we've talked about is the European Union's extreme privacy laws and the fact that they have, you know, really strict privacy laws. And I was thinking, how bizarre that the one place that has these really stringent privacy regulations now wants to collect everybody's email and phone calls in a big database. So it kind of brings up the question of, I know there's a lot of people out there that will say, well, if you don't have anything, you know, to hide, then what should it matter? Is that really the point? I mean, really? You know, when I sit down to write a letter, it's that thing where you take a piece of paper and you take a pen or a pencil and you actually, like, write on the paper. I know some of you have done this. Maybe not some of you younger people. And then you fold it up, and you put it in one of those things called an envelope, and you put a stamp on it, and you send it to the post office. Now you probably don't know what I'm talking about. But anyway, it's kind of like writing a letter. And while I don't really care a lot if people along the way were to read my letter, I'm not going to take my letter and write it on a 5x8 card and just drop it in the mail, you know? Because I don't know, it's just kind of creepy having other people read my mail, you know, where I'm talking about Aunt Sally or Uncle Johnny or, you know, whatever kinds of things you talk about when you send letters and stuff or send emails. And so I was curious how you feel about that, especially you folks in the UK, but, you know, it's not, I mean, I would be surprised, extremely surprised, if they don't already do that in the United States. Most internet traffic goes through, I think it's like four major hubs in the internet, one of which, interestingly enough, is in Arlington, Virginia, I think. Wow, fancy that. Anyhow, I'm sure that a lot of email and phone conversations get recorded. But this just seemed really odd. And then I got to thinking about it. So then I was thinking, okay, so if I didn't want somebody to read my emails, what would I do? So I did a little bit of research, and I found this this program called PGP. It stands for Pretty Good Privacy. So apparently it's a program you can download. I mean, it's been looked at by hundreds of people, so it doesn't have back doors and that kind of stuff. And you can encrypt your files and your emails, kind of like zipping up a file and giving it a password, you know? So I was thinking, well, I guess you could do that, but of course the other person has to have this PGP software so that they can have the right keys and stuff to unlock your email. And I was thinking, wow, it's pretty bizarre having to go through such lengths to keep our government from invading our privacy at such a level when, you know, the Western world, you know, Europe and the United States are all about freedom of speech and privacy and you know, making sure that people's privacies aren't violated, and you got to have a warrant, and you got to have this. And I was thinking, wow, that's the weirdest thing I've ever heard of. So just wanted to get your opinion about this, and if any of you have used this PGP stuff or another tool that you use, I'd be curious how it works, because I did some reading today, but a lot of it's a bunch of gobbledygook to me. It's a little bit confusing on exactly how it works. So if somebody wants to throw up a tutorial, actually I should go out and look. There's probably a tutorial out on YouTube somewhere, and I could probably find some information on it. But yeah, I'd be curious what your thoughts are on that. It's kind of weird.